Good evening and welcome to Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. The Arizona Board of Regents is asking lawmakers and the governor for more money to operate state universities. The board recently approved a state funding request for next fiscal year. That's about $120 million more than universities got this year. But according to most board members, the request is a fraction of what universities really need. Here to explain is chairman of the Arizona Board of Regents, Fred DuVal. Good to see you again.
Thanks. Nice to see you as well. Thanks.
$800 million some odd dollars, so it's 18% increase from the current fiscal year, fiscal year 12. Yes. Why so much of an increase?
Well, first, let's put it in perspective. State investment in the universities 4 years ago was $1.2 billion. We've taken significant cuts, over $400 million worth of cuts. That's been taken about roughly equal in actual cuts out of the universities themselves and tuition increases, which are increasingly pricing students out of our product and a real concern. So we're going to the legislature this year and say, okay, 3 years in a row of cuts. We've got money in the budget this year. Let's try and begin a process of restoring some of these cuts and get these universities back on track.
$36 million for permanent additions to base funding. Permanent additions, what are we talking about here?
Permanent additions are additions which then become part of the base and become part of the ongoing budget expectation, as opposed to one time, which in this case is largely buildings, in almost every case, large classrooms to facilitate this enormous enrollment growth that we've had, and we need a place to teach them.
Is that going to be a tough sell, the permanent aspect of all this?
Oh, you know, we're mindful of that. We are not fully out of the recession yet. The economists indicate that there'll be roughly about $300 million in new money. And our basic case to the legislature is this. About $1.5 billion of new money came in through Prop 100. That was a sales tax, which the voters passed largely on the basis of protecting education. We haven't seen any of it yet. This is the last year of the Prop 100 money. And what we're saying is one-time money, one-time needs.
The budget request also calls for funding discrepancies at universities to the tune of $15 million. Funding, what kind of discrepancies are we talking about?
Sure. Historically, the way the state has invested in universities was based upon enrollment. There's a formula based upon how large each university is. That formula hasn't been funded since 2009. As a result, because NAU and ASU have grown faster than U of A, their per student commitment from the state is less. And what the legislature has asked us to do is to isolate what that number was and then indicate to them, in order to bring those other two universities up to parity with U of A on a per student funding basis, what would that number be? And that's reflected in our request.
And Senator DeConcini, the lone dissenting voice on this budget request, apparently because he thinks it's going to hurt the U of A.
He's very concerned, and rightfully so, that instead of lifting the other two schools to catch up to the U of A on a per student basis, that what this will do is give those who are critics of the universities an opportunity to take everybody down to the lowest common denominator.
Now, was that the result of a study by the legislature, the discrepancy in funding?
It wasn't a study. It was an assignment, essentially, in the budget last year, asking us to do a study and isolate what the disparity number is. We've done that. It's about $76 million in the aggregate, and our budget proposal suggests that we deal with that disparity over a five-year basis. So $15 million of this year's request moves these universities towards parity.
Was there also, an assignment for performance-based funding to get this figured out? I know you're big on that.
Yes.
Has it been done? Is it figured out? You start, in 2014, something along those lines?
We have a draft proposal. We're going to use this year to talk it through. It's going to be complicated. It's a complete paradigm change to go from an enrollment-based model to a performance-based model. A lot of details need to be worked out. So this budget is significant. It's the first time that the universities have not gone in and said, based upon enrollment growth, here's our budget request. That would be about $173 million over the last 3 years. We're saying we recognize that old formula doesn't apply anymore. The new formula will take a year to implement performance funding. So this year we're going to do one-time needs, primarily classrooms to facilitate size, and go to performance funding next year.
And also studied the information on student-centered financial aid, just a financial aid model. What did that assignment come up with?
We've looked at best practices across the country. There's a number of ways to do it. Many states have very large financial aid packages that are state money as opposed to tuition set-asides. We've looked at those. We've looked at some states have loan forgiveness based upon students who stay in state, become taxpayers, and adding jobs. A number of different ways to do it, and we've provided a menu of choices for the legislature.
Well, quickly, back to that performance-based funding thing, which I know we've had you on the program talking about this. Not quite as tough a sell to the legislature, do you think?
I don't want to count noses yet, but it changes the whole conversation from one of here's how much more money we need to what do you want us to produce to meet the workforce needs for the future viability and competitiveness of the state of Arizona. And if that's what you want us to produce, fund us to make that happen.
Yeah. What are you hearing from lawmakers?
Very encouraged by the innovative thinking that we're showing, our willingness to change the model. If you look at the performance-based funding model, if you look at this new architecture where we've blown through the walls between the community colleges and universities, seamless transfers, hybrid pathways, et cetera, those two in combination, dramatic reform proposals, and I think the legislature, many of them, give us credit for doing something different.
Are those reforms, are there models out there? Can we look at a state and say, that's kind of what we want to aim for, or maybe that's something we want to avoid if it's just the opposite of what we're doing here?
Bits and pieces, but in its entirety, in its ambition, in its size, we are really the best practice. We are the state that other states are coming to look at and say, how it is that you're merging your systems in one integrated system that produces more degree opportunities in more places at a lower cost. That's our mantra.
And again, as we mentioned earlier in the program, this is in mind of this sales tax, this temporary sales tax, this money going away. I mean, that you talk about changing goalposts and changing targets.
That it'll go away, and next year they'll say, well, the sales tax has gone away, so we can't afford to invest in universities. Well, that probably is right. So this is the year that the taxpayers, we've made a promise to them that we're going to invest in education. There's money this year to do so, and I believe we have a moral commitment to do it.
And for the most part, the board pretty much unanimous agreement on this?
Absolutely.
All right. Very good. Good to see you again.
Good
Thanks for joining
you.
Us.
Thank you.